now. I've been waiting for this one. And he's one of Australia's most acclaimed novelists, the writer of Schindler's Ark, which was later adapted by Steven Spielberg into the Oscar-winning film Schindler's List.
87-year-old Tom Keneally has also won some of the most prestigious awards in writing, including the Man Booker Prize, the Miles Franklin Award, and he's also been made a literary lion of the New York Public Library.
Yeah, and that really is just a taste of his success. Fortunately, we have him in the studio today to talk all about that and his 36th novel, Fanatic Heart. Tom, it's such a pleasure to meet you. Thank you so much for joining us in the studio as well.
Well, thank you. This is part of my homeland, this bench. I've been here quite often.
So nice to see you again, Tom.
And met your very handsome and eternally young comrade. Oh.
Thank you, Tom. Yeah. Well, that's lovely. I'll put that on my...
That's it. Speaking of the comrades, this book, it's about a famous Irish rebel, John Mitchell. Tell us a little bit more about him.
Well, there's a whole group of Irishmen were sent to Van Diemen's Land, and the Americans financed their escape. They were political prisoners, so they weren't mentioned. Don't mention, it'll divide people, the old Irish question, you know. But he was sent to Van Diemen's Land at the height of the famine. He was shipped out of Dublin the same day that he was sentenced. Mm. And he went first to Bermuda and then he joined other Irish revolutionaries in Van Diemen's Land. And to be honest, they lived a fairly tolerable life in Van Diemen's Land. They were each restricted to their district, but they had to give their word of honour as gentlemen of the British Empire, which they were trying to bring down, that they wouldn't escape. So Mitchell was a Presbyterian minister's son from the north. He had a remarkable marriage to an illegitimate daughter of the Churchill family. And she came all the way to join him with five kids. Mm. Five kids, wow. You know, and she was approaching middle age. It was very much a young woman's journey, and the young woman was quite likely to die on the journey to Australia. But she comes with the five kids. They settle into Bothwell, Tasmania, which is a big Lanarkshire area full of Scots who drove out the Aboriginals, and that's another story. But the Mitchell was thought they've driven them out without a treaty. That's terrible. But along comes an agent from America after they've been in Van Diemen's Land, and his name is Nicaragua Smythe, and he says, I'm getting you out, and I'll help your wife pack, I'll help her sell the farm. They need you in New York. When at last he did escape, he had to ride all around New Zealand, a most spectacular escape. When at last he did, he travelled, met up with his family in Tahiti, travelled to ultimately to New York, across Nicaragua. They had six kids by then when they crossed Nicaragua on donkeys, up to New York, and he hated New York. His best mate from Van Diemen's Land and from the Revolution, Thomas Francis Marr, loved New York. He stayed in New York. He ultimately became an American Union general and was appointed by Lincoln. An Australian convict was part of Lincoln's honour guard. They didn't tell us this at school.
No.
Too bloody exciting for us colonials. He was appointed governor of Montana. And he was this other convict, Marr, and he was killed as governor of Montana by vigilantes. And so, but our bloke, Mitchell, and his beloved wife, they were very close to Oscar Wilde's mum, Speranza, who was a great Irish revolutionary, Protestant again. The Tykes, the Catholics, get all the blame for Irish revolutions, but there have been a lot of Protestants in there too. God bless the Protestants, that's what I say. And she was a great revolutionary. She was trying her hardest to get transported. But she was personal friends with the Lieutenant Governor of Ireland, so she could never get herself transported. But her beloved Thomas Francis Marr, the one that became the Union General, he was transported, of course. Right. So Mitchell
You might need a lie down, Tom, as well. Do you want to sell this book, Owen?
No, I just started.
You don't have to buy the book. We just heard of it.
Tom, I love that you are drawn to these these stories in history, and you find, as you say, the magic and the adventure that we weren't taught at school.
Well, John Mitchell's son, John C. Mitchell, who ultimately said his only concern was that he was not allowed to die for Ireland. Mm. So he did a job on his kids, as the Irish do. And he was killed while commanding Fort Sumter, the famous Fort Sumter that began the war. Mm. He had two columbards at on the opening day of the war. They were aimed at Fort Sumter. They were the first shots that blew up the parapet of Fort Sumter. So a boy from Bothwell, Tasmania, and from Newry in Ulster started the Civil War. Right. And the next day, the Charleston Mercury says this, Lieutenant J.C. Mitchell, son of our famous champion and Irish hero, John Mitchell, commanded the two columbards that were the first to hit the parapet. So we weren't told that Tasmanians started the Civil War. I've always suspected them, you know.
I could talk to you for hours.
87 years old. You've got a slew of incredible books. How many more books do you have in you, Tom?
Oh, they reckon there's a big cosmic mincer at the back bottom of the street. They're going to take me there in a year or two. But, look, I have many. Fortunately, life keeps supplying you. Now, there's a great Irish one. My grandparents immigrated after a man was murdered in their village. My grandfather has often been accused of the murder, but he wasn't. I know he didn't do it. But the man who was hanged for it has just been pardoned by the President of Ireland, so the Keneally's are back in the frame. I'd love to go back to North Cork and just live amongst the people and observe how this murder has resonated with them for the last 150 years. And write a book about it. Everything.
Of course. It's not the field, is it? The story of the field. Cork.
My grandparents come from North Cork.
Yeah, right.
Up near Kanturk, a little place called Newmarket.
Me and you need to go to the pub. We'll just get stuck into a few points later. We'll talk about this. We'll talk about all the rest of it. You are awesome. You can get a copy of Tom Keneally's novel, Fanatic Heart, at all good bookstores in person and online. Tom, thanks so much for joining us today.
Such a legend.
Again, a great treasure. And I hope you have 88-year-olds on this show.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. There's always room on the couch for you, Thomas Keneally.